Today we will do vessel aggroundings. Aggroundings of two types. One is stranding. This is accidental. So this is the most common form of aggrounding, accidental. For example, main engine failure, steering failure, plotted wrong position on the chart. So this is the most common one. And the second one is intentional. This could be three types. Intentionally, you want to aground the vessel. One is to avoid collision. In case two ships are very close to each other, that there will be a collision. This is your own ship. They're very close, maybe less than a half a mile. So it is better to go aground than to collide. So if you have a sandy or muddy land nearby, it is better to go aground than to collide. Why? Because if you collide, then there will be some damage to both vessels. Maybe one or both of them might sink also. But if you aground, then it is possible there will not be any damage to both the vessels, and later on it can be refloated. So in this case, if possible, what should be the speed when you go aground? The speed of the vessel when you go aground, this is the waterline. It should be minimum speed. Why minimum speed? Because if you go aground at high speed, vessel will go too much further in the ground and then difficult to pull back later on, difficult to refloat, and also there might be some damage. But if you go at minimum speed, there will be less damage or no damage, and secondly, easier to refloat. So this is to avoid collision, and the second will be to avoid sinking. If vessel is sinking fast and you have a muddy or a sandy shore, it is better to go aground than to sink. Why? Because if you go aground, there is chance you will refloat later on. You can employ a tug to refloat, or you can try to give full stern. And if you do not go aground and you sink, then there is a total loss. So agrounding is better than sinking, because you can refloat and you can avoid a total loss. The third type of aggrounding, intentional, is the final voyage of the vessel. That is the last voyage of the vessel in some ports in India, in Alang, Bangladesh, Pakistan. They have this practice of vessel going aground at full speed. So this final voyage speed will be maximum speed. Why maximum speed? Because they want the ship to go well inside the ground. So it is easier to cut the ship, easier to access the ship for cutting. So in this aggrounding, final voyage, what should be your drafts forward and aft? Forward draft, minimum possible. Even zero or negative is okay. Aft draft, propeller 80% immersed. So if the draft is less in high waters, the ship is normally taken for going aground in the final voyage. So ship will go well inside, and when there is low tide, it is easier to access the ship for cutting. So preferably, if this is your waterline and this is the line of the beach, your ship should be at high trim, slightly more than the trim of the beach, so that when the ship finally beaches here, her stern will beach before the bow and she will go well inside. Now, when this type of beaching takes place, how will you come to know that vessel is already beached? First thing, her speed will become zero, and then forward aft draft will also decrease. It is already 80% propeller immersion. It might come to 50% or 30%. In that case, your cooling system's intake might go above the water and you might have a blackout. And the third thing you can see is when the propeller aft draft reduces, propeller goes up, there will be racing of the engine. Racing of main engine and trip. When the main engine races, propeller RPM increases suddenly because there is less water and more air. There will be an overspeed trip. When the propeller RPM increases beyond a certain value, overspeed, engine will trip. So blackout might be there because generators will not have cooling water. Racing of engine, speed will be zero. GPS speed, zero. So this is about vessel grounding.